Good morning. Welcome to the Matchday-1 Press Conference with Trinidad and Tobago player Kimika Forbes. If you have a question, please use the raise your hand function on the screen. And we will start off with Ryan. Go ahead, Ryan.
Hi, thank you very much. Hi, Kimika. Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, how are you? I just wanted to find out, you know, what's the mood in the camp like? Has the team's confidence been dented in the aftermath of, you know, a defeat to Canada on Monday?
The mood is quite good in the camp. You know, just like piggybacking off of our coach, he said we got to dust ourselves off and move forward. And that's exactly what we did and what we portrayed in training yesterday. You know, the mood in camp have changed. Of course, we were disappointed right after the game. And I think yesterday at breakfast, you know, when we got into activation around just before lunch, you know, everything changed. You know, the girls were talking and said, listen, you know, we got to come together and do what we have to do because we have our next important game coming up. So I think we slept on it. We had like what, couple hours, and the mood in camp is not like, oh, we are defeated, because at the end of the day, we still have two games that we have to go out there and fight and go all the way out to the end.
Brian, did you have another question?
Yes, thank you for the opportunity. If I can also ask you, Kimika, what are the plans heading into this game against Costa Rica? Obviously, it's become even more important now that we perform better in the game against Costa Rica and Panama.
The game plan is fight for each other. We is all that we have. And then obviously we have to execute the game plan that the coach have in store for us and just work hard, you know, and just stay mentally focused and finish off the game strong.
And a reminder, if you have a question, to please hit the raise your hand function on the Zoom.
Okay. If I could just stick in one quick one as we wait on my colleagues to just ask another question. What are some of the things that we can work on, you know, that you guys are working on from that Canada game that we can change in the game against Costa Rica tomorrow?
Most important is the mental aspect. You know, when you get tired, you know, we have to stay focused, and that's when the communication comes, and that's when we need the communication more than anything else. And I think that more or less what is really important for us is just staying disciplined defensively and see the game through.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay, well, thank you. With that, we conclude the first part of this press conference, and in a few moments, we will begin with head coach. Thank you, everyone. We will welcome now Coach Kenwyne Jones. And if you, again, have a question, please raise the hand on the function. And we will start with Ryan. Ryan, go ahead.
Thank you very much, moderator. Hi, Kenwyne. Commiserations on the defeat against Canada.
Hi, Ryan.
Kimika just said something interesting headed into the Costa Rica game. She felt that one of the aspects of our game that we can work on is how we respond when we get a little bit tired, especially in a game against like Canada, when you could kind of get worn down. Is that a concern for you heading into the Costa Rica game?
In this tournament style, the conditions that we're playing under are not easy. First of all, we didn't get to have our meetings yet. So some of your questions kind of, you know, came before we had a conversation. I think for myself, I have to congratulate the team for the way that they perform, you know, up to the 69th minute. I think we were very organized defensively, albeit tiring when you're defending all that time. And for me, the biggest challenge that I would have for the team is for them to be better with the ball, better on the ball, you know, to give us that chance to have our attack in play. You know, in no when you look at Canada's team compared to us, you have a wealth of experience, international experience. You also have a wealth of club experience. You know, they were bringing on players that are playing for Juventus and Chelsea and PSG and West Ham and Reading, and so the golfing class, of course, in the players and the experience and their professional careers are quite big. So we have to, you know, take credit or take comfort in the fact that we held the defending Olympic champions to such a tight score, you know, based on the principles that we had, especially for that game. Looking forward, of course, we have to be different. We have to be more commanding. We have to be more confident, and believe in ourselves in what we have to do.
We kind of expect that gap that you talk about between Costa Rica and Canada to kind of get smaller in terms of Canada being the Olympic champions. What are you looking for tomorrow night? Obviously, we're now in a position where we really need to at least get a win, or at least get a point on the board.
Well, like I say, I have a big challenge for the team. You know, is to bring their personalities to the pitch, to be better on the ball, to be more confident, and to play the game. I think most of all, the difference between us and Costa Rica is the intensity that we play at, and we definitely need to bring that intensity on and off the ball. And like I say, the challenge is for us to be better on the ball.
Good luck tomorrow, Kenwyne.
Thank you very much.
Just a reminder, if you have a question for a coach, to please hit the raise your hand function on the Zoom account. Brian, go ahead.
Yeah, final question from me, Kenwyne. We obviously have a really important game tomorrow evening. What's the mood in the camp? Like, stuff like this can often, especially the manner of the defeat, conceding six goals. Has that had any sort of impact mentally on your team?
Well, as a team, I think you are going to be disappointed to lose any game. Like I said, up to 69 minutes, we were 1-0 down. The team itself, of course, you know, got a bit tired and lost focus, and obviously the goals start coming in. And like I said, Canada was able to make four subs at one time, and the amount of quality that was and experience that was coming on onto the pitch. Of course, you know, they were able to step it up again. I had a conversation after the game with the team, and like Kimika said, it's in this tournament you have to be able to try and pull the positives, you know, from previous performances, and to try and make those stronger. And then your weaknesses, you try to make better. It's not about dwelling on what happened yesterday. The most important match is always the match that you're going to play next. And that is the match that we have tomorrow. So getting back to the training pitch today, having our meetings today, is to harp on the points of what we need to do or how we need to be. most of the times in international football, you have to be able to impress your will and your style of play or your confidence or your intensity on the match itself, on the other team. And we have to do that. We have to bring the intensity. We have to be, you know, a little bit more imposing with the ball, a little bit better with the ball, to give us that chance to be able to bring our quality forward. And within the team, there is quality. The biggest thing for us is the mental aspect of it, in believing that we can and that we can always do, and to sustain that over a 90-minute period.
Thank you. And the last question is for Jumaine Cox. Go ahead, Jumaine.
Good day, Kenwyne Jones. How are you?
Good day. I'm fine and hope you're well as also.
Okay, Jumaine Cox from Tobago Channel 5.
Hi, Jumaine.
Of course, Costa Rica, according to the FIFA women's ranking, are currently in the 37th position. How much do the ranking apply to you and your team? And what are you expecting from Costa Rica in terms of style of play?
Well, we've done our analysis on all the teams, obviously, in the group that we have to play. I think up to probably maybe after 1, if I'm not mistaken, 2 o'clock this morning, we were going over it again, the latest game. And the biggest golfing class for me is just at this point is the intensity that they bring, you know, in attacking and defending, for most parts of the game, if not the majority. That is something that we will have to match and also get above at times. If we have to bring a positive result to the game, the mental aspect of that desire and that will to go and do the hard work over that 90-minute period is what we need to do. I don't think that you know player for player they're that much better than us. Our players is just about the confidence to go and play on this platform and bring their skills forward. When we do that, when we have the intensity, when we have that confidence, when we, you know, try to play the ball, the team, you know, I believe can stand with most teams in Concacaf. It's just us being able to bring that on that day, and you know, hopefully the result will take care of itself.
And coach, we do have a question from the chat, and they are asking, do you have a fully fit team for tomorrow's match?
Well, the majority of our squad, I'd say, is fit. You know, when you come into tournaments like this, sometimes based on the pool of players that we have, you know, you would have players with niggles. Some you have to give a little bit more time to be able to come back. To back to the team, back to playing. But at the same time, you know, most of our squad is fully fit and raring to go.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you all. With that, we conclude this press conference with Trinidad and Tobago national team. Thank you very much.
Thank you.